We have our one and only Evan Closky, right?
That's right, my other favorite Evan. He's our former KREM 2 sports anchor. He probably looks familiar for you. He's joining us from San Antonio.
Step foot in a building.
Which one's the better Evan?
Me, the first Evan, the one who set the road for all other Evans to follow.
You're now the San Antonio Evan, I'm the Spokane Evan.
You're Noonies to me, and that's all that's important.
Deal.
Welcome to San Antonio. We are in Travis Park right now, which is in the heart of downtown. The sun is coming up right in front of me, so you're going to see me blown out a little bit at this point. But nonetheless, we are 12 hours away from kickoff in the 2018 Alamo Bowl. Iowa State taking on Washington State. And Washington State on the precipice of its first ever 11-win season. And when you think about that, you have to take a step back and just really drink that in. That is an amazing accomplishment if it can happen this season. 10 wins is an amazing accomplishment already. But we were actually met up with Hussein Abdullah, a former Coug, not too long ago. And if you said that this team was ever going to win 11 games within the decade, you would have thought it had been crazy. But he is down here in San Antonio, and he is having a grand old time with a lot of other Cougs.
It's been exciting. I think there's a different spirit that we have as Cougs. So when you see us running around, having fun, winning games, especially being a former player, it's just beyond exciting.
So very nice to see him as well as some other Cougs in the area. Now, let's break down the three keys for Washington State to win. It's game day, so let's talk a little football. Now, my first key is that Iowa State has a wonderful quarterback in Brock Purdy, but Washington State has to win that quarterback battle. If Washington State can rattle the true freshman QB, then they really can have a chance to storm past Iowa State. Now, we were able to talk with Mike Leach yesterday about the freshman quarterback. He actually took over halfway through the season and has been a big reason for the turnaround, and Leach has been pretty impressed.
Good player. You know, I think the best thing he does, what he's done impressively, is he's been able to effectively take the reins at a young age and elevate the players around him. And I think that's the hardest thing.
Now, the second key will be for Washington State's offense to stay on the field. We saw it against Cal and Washington. This group can get stagnant at times, and when they do that, they create very little margin for error for the defense. As long as Mike Leach is the head coach, offense will always be the name of the game, and the Cougs cannot be squandering drives left and right against one of the better defenses this team has faced all year long. Move the chains and make Iowa State's offense beat you. Now, last but not least, win the fourth quarter. And I know this seems a bit cliche, but both Purdy and Minshew are top five in passer efficiency in the fourth quarter. Both are clutch players, and honestly, I think this is going to be a really close game. Four of the last six Alamo Bowls have been within a score. Also, the last three Alamo Bowls have been won by the Big 12. This game could come down to the final drive, and winning in the final minutes, in my opinion, is who will decide the winner. Now it's time for a prediction, right? And let me say this, I love the Cougs. I love covering them. I love the Inland Northwest. I bought a Gardner Minshew Heisman shirt. I think Iowa State wins 20-17 in a very, very close, exciting game. I said it's going to come down to the final minutes, and if it's a defensive battle, I just have to give Iowa State the edge. So that is the honest truth. I know I'm supposed to be a homer. Jen, you can pick the Cougs against me, and you can be right, I can be wrong.
Oh, well, I like that in any situation, Evan.
I say, if anything, at least Evan's being honest. So that's all we need.
That's all I'm trying to do, all right? Transparency.
Oh, that's what I'm here for.
How jealous I am that it is sunny out there in San Antonio right now.
Yeah, what's the weather like today?
Though. It's going to reach highs of 60s, which is great. But right now it is a bit windy and cold for San Antonio standards. I know you guys are battling the snow, and I feel for you. I really do. But
being
it's
a
about
anchor,
mid-40s right now. About mid-40s right now. The sun is coming out, so it is warming up.
All right, Evan, just to give you a little taste of what it's like back here in Spokane, it's 24 degrees currently in Spokane.
Oh, yummy.
Yeah, right? Exciting.
All right, Evan Klosky, thanks so much for checking in.